three-girl and three-boy choristers, chosen by the judges in the semi-finals, will sing again. One will receive the title highly commended by the judges, the other will lift the trophy to become the BBC Young Chorister of the Year.
Welcome to the final of the BBC Young Chorister of the Year competition 2020 from Songs of Praise and BBC Radio 2. From the hundreds who applied, there are just six finalists left. To help them prepare for today, we secured the help of two fellow Songs of Praise presenters who were also young choristers and whose music regularly tops the classical charts, Katherine Jenkins and Alid Jones. Nice bit of healthy competition between you two there, I should think.
Oh, for sure.
Katherine, you've been working with the girls. Did it take you back to your young chorister days?
Oh, it really did. I had such a lovely day with them, and they're so enthusiastic, some really talented girls. I can't wait to see them perform today.
Me either. Introduce them to us.
We've got three wonderful girls on my team. First of all, we've got Leah from Northern Ireland. She's got a very unique voice, and she's actually chosen a modern worship song. We've got Ruby from Surrey, and she performed a beautiful piece of Handel's Messiah. And then we've also got Josie from Staffordshire. And she's got a very pure, angelic voice, which I think everybody's going to really enjoy.
Thank you, Katherine. Now, Alid.
Yes.
You've been coaching the boys. Tell me about your team.
Well, I've got one of the winners in my team, of course. Thank you also for introducing me as a young chorister. Yeah, cheers. To be honest with you, I've really loved working with the boys. Not so much coaching them, but getting inspiration from them. They're fantastic. I've got Charlie, who's got a voice of an angel and a smile that could melt hearts. Look at that smile. Come on, please, look at that smile.
I know, and he's a redhead, so I'm already on his team.
Oh, there you go. We've got Sebastian, a very mature voice, a strong, powerful singer. And Alexander, who is the coolest choir boy in the world, turned up to our little coaching session and sang Oh for the Wings of a Dove with his hands in his pockets. That's how cool he is. An amazing voice, too. So, three great guys.
Wonderful. Thank you so much. It's time to welcome back our judges. They are world-renowned composer, conductor and choir leader, John Rutter. Leading soprano and past winner of the Radio 2 Chorister Competition, Laura Wright. And the director of music at Chapel Royal Hampton Court Palace, Carl Jackson. As today is the second Sunday of Advent, all our finalists have chosen seasonal carols and songs, and we have a real treat in store because later in the programme, whoever wins the competition will perform one of our best loved carols with Alid and Katherine. And I'm sure our first chorister is hoping it will be him. He's Charlie and he sings at Wakefield Cathedral.
I to know that your baby boy would save our sons and daughters? Did you know that your baby boy is heaven's perfect lamb? This child that you've delivered will soon deliver you. Mary, did you know that your baby boy would give sight to a blind man? Mary, did you know that your baby boy would calm the storm with his hands? Did you know that your baby boy has walked where angels trod? When you kiss your little baby, you kiss the face of God. Mary, did you know? Did you know that your baby boy is heaven's perfect lamb? The sleeping child you're holding is the great
Vamos, carmine letitiae, devotere damos, gaudete, gaudete, Christus est natus, ex Maria Virgine, gaudete. Deus homo factus est, natura mirante, mundus renovatus est, a Christo regnante, gaudete, gaudete, Christus est natus, ex Maria Virgine, gaudete. Petandito, unde luxes ota salus invenito, natus ex Maria Virgine, gaudete.
Holy night. Charlie has this purity in his voice that I just love listening to, and I thought he placed every single note so well.
His breath control was marvellous. His tuning was spot on.
If I were being fussy, I'd just a touch more energy with bleak, the K, bleak, and God, just a touch more.
Leah, you can see, has such a strong faith, and for her, the music is completely based in that world for her. You can see she tells the story, she believes every word she's singing.
Mary, did you know that your baby boy...
There are quite a few moments in there where she has a sustained note. She just needs to watch the tuning. In one or two places, I just felt just a little lift to get right onto the note.
A raise of the eyebrows.
Precisely,
what I
used to do. Yes, absolutely.
Sebastian and Gaudete.
He showed us every technical aspect of his voice, and there was real light and shade, and I thought that was really impressive to listen to.
I would have liked it to be a little more rhythmically incisive. Dash, 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 dot, dot, dash, dot, dash. Just need a little more point.
Silent night.
Ruby and Silent Night, well, gosh, you're putting your head in the lion's mouth singing that one, because everybody knows it, everybody's got their own idea of how fast it should go.
to sing that verse a cappella and to hold everybody's attention, I think that was a really brave thing to do.
I would have liked a little more variety between the verses, but gosh, she's got quite a big voice for her age.
Alexander, it's just effortless for him.
Amid the roses, Mary sits.
He's got a beautiful sense of style. He sounds like a human being. He doesn't sound like a disembodied angel.
He was a natural, and that came across in the way he sang and also in the quality of the tone.
Josie has got a real sense of the text. I think her voice is still under development, but I think there's great potential there.
She did create the atmosphere at the start, and I think it's grabbing the listener. I mean, you take them on that musical journey.
I would have loved her to have even more diction with the words that she's saying, but apart from that, for me, it was a really great performance. So the recipient of the highly commended award showed absolute brilliance in their tone, the quality of the voice, but above all, we agreed that there was just such a wonderful atmosphere about that piece of music. So the winner of the highly commended award goes to Josie.
I will, and there has to be a winner, but you know this is more than just a competition. It's really a celebration of all the young choristers of Britain who give their time, their talents, and their dedication to make our church and cathedral choirs what they are today. You are the future of choral music. We salute all of you. And the winner, the BBC Young Chorister of the Year, is Alexander.
Congratulations, Alexander. Very well done. How do you feel?
Great.
We have something very special to end the competition. A beautiful carol featuring all the finalists and led by Katherine and Aled, and our winner, Alexander, the BBC Young Chorister of the Year 2020.
Brightly shine, it is the night of the dear Saviour's birth.